Hey guys, welcome to WPX Fox, and today we are going to talk about GDR3 update on Windows Phone, which came out yesterday and was rolled out to most of the devices. Developer unlock, or if you can create account using the App Studio, you can unlock it that way too. So in this video, we'll compare GDR2, which is on my Lumia 1020 on my left, and GDR3, which is on 920 on my right. So the first thing we need to check is how to close an app. So you can just do a long press on the back key. And in GDR2, you can see there is no option to close this directly. You need to go to the app and then, you know, tap back key and then quit the app. But in GDR3, you have option to close it using the close button right on individual apps. So that makes it easy to close the apps quickly now. So now this can be used as an app switcher or app closer. Second thing, screen rotation or the screen orientation. Now whenever you wanted to watch a movie, you will go in a portrait mode and watch the movie. But as soon as you know you change your orientation, for some reason, the video also used to change their orientation. And this is also possible for all the apps. So now we have a new setting called as screen rotation. Let me give you a closer look. You can see screen rotation is available in 920, which is GDR3, while in GDR2, this is not available. So now, if I want to do a screen lock here, I can just go to screen rotation and I can just change my orientation and say turn off. So this rotation is now fixed, because if I go back and even if I change my orientation, it remains the same. And if you take a look on the screen rotation, it says locked landscape left. So if you would have done it like this, it would have remained as long as locked landscape right. So this is how you use the screen rotation. Now there's no quick settings as for any other settings in my Lumia. So we got to live with that until Microsoft decides, you know, we need that too. Better storage management. In GDR3, when you go to your settings, you have phone storage, which you will see it will take a while to load. There you go. While in GDR2, you have phone storage, which loads instantly, but there is nothing you can do when you tap on it. While in GDR2, give me a closer look. You can actually tap on it and you get to see a lot of details of what is taking space, apps and games. Then you can tap on it and get more details, but you need to go to your apps and games and then uninstall it. There is no direct way to do it here. What is important is sure that you have music, videos, pictures, documents, email messaging, system. What is important is temporary files. You can go here and then you can hit delete and it starts deleting the temporary file. Let's see how much we recover. And this is a background task, so you can come back later and, you know, check out what has been deleted and how much space has been recovered. You also have option of Internet Explorer settings, so you can go and delete history and, you know, delete files. Now I wanted to show you that under advanced settings, you can go to manage storage and unify a couple of files here. Now this has never happened for me before. So you have phone has 500 MB of space left for websites to store files. That said, now we'll move to another settings that's called as driving mode. You saw there is a tab already available here. This driving mode helps me set up a device over Bluetooth, so and it lets me reject calls. So let's say if I'm driving and I don't want to pick up calls and all those stuff, you can do that. So you can go to calls and text and set up text replies for calls or emails or whatever you want, and add devices. You can have multiple devices, so I can connect to my Bluetooth device, which I have right here, and I can reject calls and send automatic text reply. There is a complete video, please follow the link. Now there are a couple of Bluetooth enhancements available. The first one is if I go to Bluetooth, you have a new profile. When you tap on advanced, it says connect in a different way to use speech with Bluetooth in my car. So if you do that and, you know, connect with your Bluetooth device, it makes sure that it works accordingly. So I can just
connect it.
There you go, I've connected. Now it makes sure that it's up. And you can say start driving mode. So yeah, I'll do that. So my driving mode is actually started in this mobile. And it will start automatically rejecting text calls and all those stuff. So this is how basically you do. You connect according to your Bluetooth profile, and so that it works with voice and everything. So that was driving mode and connecting with Bluetooth in a profile which was different. It was not available before. Now there is also called as internet sharing, which is possible through Bluetooth. We'll demo that in a different video later on. Now that said, there are a lot of couple of small changes I would like to tell you. That first one is, if you go to Internet Explorer, advanced settings, you can actually have Google as your search provider, which was dropped off from GDR to 2, I guess, and now it's available. This doesn't work with the search key here, but it works when you type something on browser and just hit enter. It starts searching in Google then. Then you have a dictionary setting, which I will have to take a look where it is. If you go to settings keyboard, you will see there's option as advanced. And if you select that, then I will say it says switch back to letters after I've typed emote icon. So after, as soon as you type emote icon, it will, you know, switch back to text mode so that you can start typing, because generally we add like one or two emote icons and do the job. Now there's another update that's with ringtones and settings. So, you know, if you go to an individual contact, so let's say if I pick up one contact here, I can just go and edit and, you know, add ringtones for a lot of things. Like I can do it for text, ringtone, for emails, and all the stuff can be done. So I can just go ringtone and add a couple of ringtones here, add a text tone, add something else, and then, you know, attach ringtones and like that. Apart from that, there are a couple of other announcements that they're trying to figure it out. Like, you know, the Gears update is available, so that displays the progress bar. Then you can use internet, like Wi-Fi, when you're first initially setting up your phone and all those stuff. So that's pretty much about the GDR3 update for Windows Phone. Do let us know if you find out something new so that we can share it and probably create another video. Now, some of the things which I have skipped here will come out in the next video or in consecutive videos. Keep an eye on that and make sure to follow us. Thanks for watching.